If we're looking at a sequence of letters, what's likely to come next? This is a prediction problem, where, given a letter, the goal is to predict the next letter in the sequence. But this prediction is impossible without the context of the sequence of letters. For example, here, O is followed by three different letters. But in context, the next letter becomes easier and easier to predict as the sequence progresses. Long short-term memory networks, or LSTMs, are designed for applications where the input is an ordered sequence, where information from earlier in the sequence may be important. LSTMs are a type of recurrent network, which are networks that reuse the output from a previous step as an input for the next step. Like all neural networks, the node performs a calculation using the inputs and returns an output value. In a recurrent network, this output is then used along with the next element as the inputs for the next step, and so on. In an LSTM, the nodes are recurrent, but they also have an internal state. The node uses an internal state as a working memory space, which means information can be stored and retrieved over many time steps. The input value, previous output, and the internal state are all used in the node's calculations. The results of the calculations are used not only to provide an output value, but also to update the state. Like any neural network, LSTM nodes have parameters that determine how the inputs are used in the calculations. But LSTMs also have parameters known as gates that control the flow of information within the node. In particular, how much the saved state information is used as an input to the calculations. These gate parameters are weights and biases, which means the behavior depends on the inputs. So, for example, an input of Q doesn't need much past information. The next letter is almost certainly a U. But an input of E, well, we might need to recall much more past information. Similarly, there are gates to control how much of the current information is saved to the state, and how much the output is determined by the current calculation versus the saved information. So LSTM nodes are certainly more complicated than regular recurrent nodes, but this makes them better at learning the complex interdependencies in sequences of data. And ultimately, they're still just a node with a bunch of parameters. And these parameters are learned during training, just like with any other neural network.